Before we learn how to factor a difference of squares, let's talk about the meaning of these three words. Difference of squares. So what is the difference of squares? The three words here actually already tell us the exact meaning. Difference of squares is the difference, right? Difference of who? Of squares. That's it. So for example, difference of x squared and y squared, right? Or difference of x squared and 5 squares. Or difference of a squared and b squared. That's it. Okay, now we know the meaning of difference of squares. Let's talk about how to factor a difference of two squares. For example, to factor the difference of a squared and b squared, this is what I want you guys to do. Write out two brackets. And inside the first bracket, I want you to put a plus sign. Inside the second bracket, I want you to put a minus sign. And this is what you do. It's really cool, and it's very, very easy. So guys, here we have the difference of square of the first guy and the square of the second guy. Who is the first guy? A. And this is what I want you to do. Inside each bracket, put A as the first guy. Now, here we have the square of the second guy. Who is the second guy right here? B. Then inside each bracket, let's put B as the second guy. That's it. Guys, there you go. That's the formula for factoring a difference of squares. A squared minus B squared can be factored as A plus B times A minus B. Okay? So guys, for example, now if I change the first guy as instead of A, if I change to 3A, same thing. Now, first guy is 3A, no problem. The first guy in each bracket now must be 3A. Just like that. Right? Very easy. Now, what if the second guy now is, say, 5B? Easy. Inside each bracket, make sure the second guy is 5B. So guys, here we go. 3a squared minus 5b squared is 3a plus 5b and 3a minus 5b. Right? Okay? So now, let me show you a typical question you will see on your test. Factor this guy. 9a squared minus 16. Well, guys, let's set it up. If we can somehow rewrite this question as the difference of two squares, then now to factor the difference of two squares, we can write it as the product of two brackets. And remember, inside the first bracket, we have to put plus, right? And inside the second bracket, we have to put minus, right? Cool. So now, guys, now the question you have to ask yourself now is, guys, for the first guy here, 9a squared, can we write this guy as the square of someone? Sure. Because 9a squared is the square of 3a, right? Let's double check. What's 3 squared? 9. What's a squared? A squared. That's it. Right? Okay, next. Now, how about the second term right here, 16? Can we write 16 as the square of somebody? Of course. 16 is the square of 4. Ah, so now, if we rewrite this question as the difference of two squares, Now we know how to factor this. It's super easy, right? So here we go, guys. Who is the first guy here? 3a. So we want to make sure that in each bracket, the first guy is 3a, 3a. Now, who is the second guy right here? 4. So we just have to make sure inside each bracket, the second guy is 4. And we are done. So to factor 9a squared minus 16, well, first of all, we rewrite the question as the square of 3a minus the square of 4. And once we write it this way, well, we can do factoring very, very easily, right? So 9a squared minus 16 equals 3a plus 4 times 3a minus 4. We're done. I know I've always told you guys you should never memorize math. You should try to understand it, and hopefully after you understand it, it sticks right here. Then you don't have to memorize anything, right? So now we know how the formula of difference of squares works. And let me prove the formula. And it's actually very easy to prove the formula. All we have to do is just multiply everything out by doing FOIL. Do you still remember FOIL? F-O-I-L. FOIL stands for what? F stands for first. O stands for outer. I stands for inner. L stands for last. So whenever we have two terms, multiply by two terms, this is what we do, FOIL. Okay? So now, here it is. First thing we do is what? Multiply the first terms inside each bracket. Right? So guys, this is first. Right? And guys, if we multiply the first terms inside each bracket, we have a times a, we have a squared, right? Cool. Next, O stands for outer, right? So guys, look at this expression right here. We see four items. Who are the outer two items? They will be the A and the B, right? The outer two items. See, this will be the inner two items. And this will be the outer two items, right? So next, let's multiply the outer two items. Right? Okay. So now we have A multiplied by negative b, we get negative ab. Okay, next, what do? We multiply the inner two items, right? So guys, this is the inner. So now multiply the inner two items, we have positive b times a, we have positive ba. At the end, we multiply the last items. So the last items inside each bracket. So then we have this then, right? This is the last, right? The last item inside each bracket. Okay, so we have positive b times negative b. Then we have negative b squared. Okay, guys? So after multiplying out everything, by doing FOIL, we have this. Okay. And guys, would you say BA? You can also write it as AB. Right? It's like this. 5 times 3, would you say it's the same thing as 3 times 5? Because 5 times 3 is 15. 3 times 5 is also 15. Right? So BA, B times A, is the exact same thing as A times B, right? Cool. So now, let's simplify this then. So here we have a squared. And here we have minus b squared. And you might be wondering, what happened to the middle two terms? Well, look at this, guys. Negative ab, positive ab, they what? Canceled out, right? Yeah. So there we go. I successfully proved a plus b times a minus b equals a squared minus b squared right here.